There's a hidden force that controls you. It controls what you think, what you perceive, the reality you live in, the ideas that come to you, how you feel, and therefore it's going to determine how successful and happy you're going to be. It's not your mindset, it's not your thoughts, and if you never take control of it, it will continue to control you. I know it's a very intense intro, but it's very true. Let me show you what it is and give you practical examples to use it to your advantage, like I did with Jan and Ben, two of my subscribers. I first discovered it when I was building my first business. E-commerce was highly competitive, and I went from barely getting by to absolutely skyrocketing my business after figuring out this force, because it allowed me to see things that others didn't. It gave me brilliant ideas, it revealed the solutions to almost any problem I was facing, and it showed me exactly what I needed to focus on. I know, you're wondering, what is it? And that's exactly what it is. Get it? It is the questions that you ask yourself, subconsciously or consciously, in the moment and throughout your life. Let me explain. See, at first, the only question that was on my mind was, how can I just make enough money to pay myself? And that's all I focused on and therefore perceived. It felt like a grind. I saw problems everywhere. Everything was just so hard. Until I listened to this podcast episode where this guy challenged me to ask a higher quality question. And the question was something along the lines of, what would someone in my position have to do to reach 10 times more in the next 6 months? And that question, no exaggeration, changed my life. I was seeing everything from a completely different perspective. And really, my perception of reality shifted. Ideas I would have never had before started flooding in. Problems that seemed so hard to overcome were now just minor inconveniences. And it became crystal clear what I had to focus on in order to get there. If you've seen the video where I talk about my whole business journey, then you know what happened. All of it was just one question. I noticed that the most successful people have mastered this skill, which is asking high quality questions. I stumbled upon this story of this guy who helped the billionaire Ray Dalio publish his best-selling book Principles. And as a thank you, Ray Dalio offered to mentor him. Before I begin telling you what I think, I want to establish that I'm a dumb sh**. But whenever this guy was facing a challenge and asked Ray for advice, he didn't give him any answers. All he did was ask higher quality questions, which then cracked open his mind and allowed him to find the solutions to the answers. The questions, which eventually resulted in him launching a product that made $2 million the first day. And you see this strategic questioning ability in other mega successful people like Elon Musk, Steve Jobs, Joe Rogan.
I never done answer.
Want to do it now?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Well, maybe. Why are questions so powerful? Because they determine what you focus on, which then creates your reality. See, there's an infinite amount of information out there. Reality is so insanely complex that our brains can't even comprehend it. And our brain puts a filter on things, so we only see a tiny portion of the infinitely complex reality that's out there. And with new questions, we can change that filter and therefore perceive things that we didn't see before. Think of your brain as a search engine. There's hundreds of millions of thoughts that you can access, and depending on what you type in, you're gonna get an answer, no matter what you type in. So why don't we get very strategic of what we type into that search engine? I came across this Einstein quote, and it said this: if I had an hour to solve a problem and my life depended on the solution, I would spend the first 55 minutes determining the proper question to ask. For once I know the proper question, I could solve the problem in less than 5 minutes. And therefore, any problem you have is just an unanswered question to which you just haven't asked the right question yet to solve it. What does this look like in a practical example? As you might know, I like to have calls with subscribers and help them with their goals. And Jan, for example, didn't know what to do. He was working for a startup, had a little side hustle going, but he wanted to start a long-term business. So I said, let's go Einstein on this.
So let's really define what is the question.
How to achieve financial freedom, and I think I have the answer already.
So that's not really the question, right?
And we just kept digging to find the right question to ask.
The question is,
what should I focus on?
I already have the right skills.
Is it risky?
When is the best time?
Until it became very clear.
Because he actually knew the answer to all these questions already.
Is the question right now, how do I approach this properly so I minimize the risk and maximize the chance of success?
Yeah.
And once we realized that that's what was holding him back, we made a plan to minimize the risk, and boom. He was ready to move forward.
I just have to take the next step. I don't know why I did not do it before.
Because you just didn't know what question to ask, and therefore you focused on the wrong things. That's it.
Questions. Asking better questions is a skill that you need to learn. It takes practice. So let me give you some quick tips. Number one, beware of underlying assumptions. If the question is, can I become more confident? The underlying assumption is that you might not be able to, and it might be impossible, which is a stupid question to ask, because of course you are. So instead, how can I become more confident would be much better, because it assumes it is possible. The question is, how? And to upgrade that question, you could ask, how can I become even more confident? Which acknowledges that you are, of course, already confident in some areas and in some situations. It just feels way more empowering. Secondly, be specific. So if you ask yourself, how can I become even more confident in the next 10 minutes, in the next 10 days, you get very different answers. Or let's say you ask, how can I make some money versus how can I make $10,000 versus how can I make $10,000 next month? And thirdly, you can add some restrictions. Let's say you ask, how can I do that, make all that money, doing something fun? Better questions, better answers. I love this stuff. I even created my own journal with guided exercises and guides on how to ask the right questions and come up with the answers and all that. So I haven't launched it. I don't know why. Just didn't know if people wanted it. If you do, let me know. Till then, I'll just use it for myself. Here's where it gets a bit scary. So far, I've only talked about short-term questions that you ask in the moment to solve some problems and overcome challenges. But there are also questions that we repeatedly ask again and again long-term, and it shapes your entire worldview, how you view your life, and also how you make decisions in your life. And there's always one main question that is most pressing in our life. If you're one of us and you're hungry for more in life, it's because your main question that you keep asking yourself is far different than that of normal people. Because normies ask themselves, how do I get by? You know, how can I have the most fun with the least amount of work? Or things like, why am I not good enough? And on the other hand, our main questions might be something like, how can I be successful? How do I get to the next level? Or when I ask Graham for his most pressing question,
just, will I have regret for doing or not doing something in the future?
And you can clearly see how this has shaped Graham's life, but it can also be something very disempowering. I know for me, the question that I used to have was something along the lines of, will I make it? Will I be successful? And it definitely gave me a lot of drive, but with that question, the way it was phrased, it came with a bunch of doubt, it came with a bunch of fear, worry, uncertainty. And sometimes that question forms after a specific event that happened in our life, and then we keep repeating the same question over and over again. And that was the case for Ben.
My head is a little crooked. My collarbone broke when I was born, so, and there were some kids that had come over and they're like, why do you look so weird?
After such events, especially when we're young, we usually ask ourselves, how do I make sense of this? What does this mean for me? And for Ben, it was this.
The way I look or the way I am is seen as a problem by other people, something that they don't want to associate with.
Which then created one of many questions that controls life.
What's the worth in trying if you're just gonna fail? You cause more problems than you fix.
Can you see how this would trap you in a reality where life is just unfair? But sometimes all it takes is a high quality question that we never asked before that changes everything.
One of the advantages of looking the way you look, which sounds super weird, because obviously your brain goes, there's no advantages, but that's not true.
Yeah.
See, this is when you know you've asked a question that he's never asked himself before. When your brain is digging for answers, and with new questions comes a new perspective and a new reality. And he went on to tell me how it's actually given him the drive to work harder in everything he does.
It's driven me to, I'd say, just work harder in general.
It taught him not to take himself too seriously, motivated him to become fit. And it also naturally filters out people that are superficial, which you don't want in your life anyways.
There's so much more benefit to having it than not having it, I guess.
This is not some delusional positive thinking. There's an infinite list of disadvantages, but there's also an infinite list of advantages. And why would you only look at one of these lists? That's delusional. Now, I wonder what your main question is. If all this video does is inspire one person to maybe upgrade their main question from something that's just about them and focus on all the disempowering and depressing parts of reality to maybe something that has more meaning, like, how can I be the light at the end of the tunnel for others? How can I make the world a better place? How can I serve humanity? See you in the next one.